We're trying to solve a problem about the most efficient way to have an electric wire go from a power station to an island a mile off the coast of a river, based on the fact that it costs a certain amount of money to lay wire underground, but more money if we're going to lay the wire underwater. So we came up with a function for that in the last video. And what we're going to do now is, since we want to find the value of x that minimizes this function, because we want to find the minimum cost for this project. So we want to find the value of x that makes this cost as low as possible. And so to find the minimum value of a function, we are going to take the derivative of c. Okay, so c prime of x. Why don't we do one thing to make this look a little bit cleaner? Since we know that the square root is kind of something we can use the power rule on, why don't we change this into an exponential form? So we'll just write this as 120 minus 30, sorry, that should be 30x, I apologize for that, plus 50 times x squared plus 1 to the 1/2 power. Okay, so what is the derivative of that? Well, 120, we'll just go term by term. What's the derivative of 120? 120 is a constant, so that derivative is 0. So we got that going for us at least. What's the derivative of negative 30x? This is just a linear term. So the derivative of that is negative 30. All right, this last one is going to make up for the prettiness of the first two. So the first thing is we've got this 50, so we can kind of pull that out and just think about the derivative of this. So how do we find the derivative of that? What do we need to use? Well, we've got an exponent here, so we could use the power rule, except that it's not an x inside, it's an expression. So we have to use the chain rule for this. All right, so the derivative of this is, the derivative of something to the 1/2 power is gonna be 1/2 times that thing, which is x squared plus 1. And then we need to reduce the exponent by 1/2, by 1. So that's gonna become negative 1/2. And then we have to multiply that by the derivative of the inside function. So the derivative of x squared plus 1 is 2x. So we need to close that and then close the big parentheses. Okay, so there's our derivative. Let's see if we can clean it up a little bit. So I'm multiplying 1/2 times 2x here, so I can cancel out those 2s at least. And so that will be negative 30 plus 50 times x times x squared plus 1 to the negative 1/2 power. We've got a negative exponent here. How can we turn that into a positive exponent? Well, it'll be a positive exponent if we move it into the denominator. So that'll be x squared plus 1 to the 1/2 power. Okay, and there's one more thing we can do to clean this up is we can turn this back into a square root notation. So we've got that c prime of x is equal to negative 30 plus 50x over the square root of x squared plus 1. Okay, so that was a little hideous, but it was a real life function for a real life situation. And we want to make sure this wire is laid as cheaply as possible. So it was worth a little bit of time to make sure we, you know, went through the effort of calculating that derivative. In the next video, we're going to wrap up this problem by using that first derivative to actually find the lowest cost wire situation that can be set up for this.